How unusual that you two have decided to come to our rural district. There's really nothing interesting here.
It has gotten so cold outside. We weren't expecting any visitors. The soup is all we have. Please, have as much as you want.
Oh, yes, please.
Thanks. Smells great.
Wouldn't you like some, dear? Don't you like potato soup?
No. It's not that. I'm all right for now. Thank you for your hospitality, though.
No trouble at all. Please let me know if there's anything we can do. We are the only ones who live here, and it's so rare that we get any visitors.
So are you two really the only ones who live here?
Why do you ask?
Well, it was pretty foggy, so I couldn't tell for sure. But this building looked like an old church or something. Seems a little big just for the two of you.
You're right. In the 9th century, a saint from Ireland named Daniel Scotius built a place of worship here to appease monsters and evil spirits. That was how the Nemeton Monastery started, or so I heard.
Monsters. Is that right?
Yes. What about them?
You might not believe this, but we saw a monster on our way here.
Is that so? You saw it too.
You mean that monster's been around for a while?
Well, we've been taking care of the monastery for a number of years, but from about 6 months ago, monsters have been appearing.
We see them more and more every month.
I used to be a sailor. I'm not afraid of any monsters.
Oh, dear. What if something terrible happens to you?
We almost got killed back there. Now we're out of bullets.
That's not good. The monsters might try and attack you again. I'll spare you some bullets.
Thanks. That'd be great.
Looking after others. He's so wonderful at that.
So, have you two been together long?
Yes, quite a while. Now, all he does is paint and maintain this old building. That's his daily routine. But back in the old days...
Thanks, Ogden. I owe you one. Now this would make good rations. Let's take some with us.
I can't believe it. Are you still hungry?
I didn't have anything to eat or drink for 3 days. Of course I'm hungry. Speaking of which, you wasted all of that food. What's wrong with you?
Yeah, if it weren't poison, then I would have had some.
Pardon?
I said, if the soup weren't poisoned, then I would have had some. Got it?
Poisoned? No way.
Just a little bit. I smelled some poisonous plant.
What's happened?
Oh, I can tell you how you're going to feel. In about half an hour, you won't be able to move your body. If you don't find an antidote, you'll definitely die.
So they really were trying to kill us. But why?
Don't know. But it seems they're quite used to doing it this way. They must be hiding something. Listen, Edward. I'm going to try to cure you now. But you have to promise that when I do, you won't get mad and rush back to that couple right away. It's safer if we pretend we're dead and continue exploring this building. I think we'll find something interesting for sure.
Oh. My head. Oh. What happened? Oh. Yes. That's right. That monster. Oh.
Who on earth are you two?
Hey! We rescued you, and that's your way of saying thanks?
Little did I know that these days were into rescuing perfect strangers.
You.
My name is Koudelka, and this is Edward. Would you mind telling us how you ended up collapsed on this path?
My name is James. James O'Flaherty. I've been searching for something, and it took me to the monastery. Little did I know that it become a breeding ground for demonic spirits.
Then how did you get in here dressed like that?
Through the main gate, of course. The caretakers welcomed me with open arms.
That husband and wife team? And the food? Was there no poison in your food?
What are you talking about? Are you out of your mind?
Those caretakers tried to poison and kill us.
That's not funny. I find it inappropriate for you to try to dupe an upstanding believer of the Christian faith.
So nothing happened to you then?
Of course not. Not until I encountered that monster.
Yeah? And we're the ones who took care of that monster. Far be it from me to expect any words of gratitude from you.
I see. And I can tell from your appearances that the power of your faith alone was not enough to smooth things out with that monster.
It wasn't the kind of problem that faith alone could solve.
Ugh. Look at this plinth. It's broken now, but holy water ran from it until recently. But I've become distracted. Almighty God, please give me the strength to ward off these monsters.
I can see that we've wasted our time here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go, Koudelka.
Just a minute. Although I'm under the protection of the Lord, it doesn't hurt to take precautionary measures. I think I'll go with you.
Thank you. What a dark and depressing building. Even with the temple, you can't feel the presence of the Lord's light. I can't believe I stepped foot in this place.
Where all have gone, and all must go, to be the nothing that I was. I am born to life and living woe.
Lord Byron, no? I am not an admirer of his. In the first place, his poetry is unrefined.
And who gave you the right to judge the refinement of poetry?
Poetry should delve into the depths of the souls of the faithful. And others. It should inspire the soul as do Alexander Pope or George Herbert.
If they have the power to do away with these evil spirits, I'd choose anyone. Even that dear old carpenter's son.
Blasphemous! So Pagan! How dare you utter such words of sin?
To seek help from someone you've never met before is ridiculous, especially when people are dying from hunger every single day in London.
They're all filthy and immoral little beggars that deserve to die.
Heaven is...
That doesn't sound like a demonic spirit to me.
The noise is coming from that building over there.
The poison didn't kill us, so now they're taking the fast and easy way now.
Don't be ridiculous!
Why don't you ask the bullets who's being ridiculous?
You idiots!
Thank you.
Goodness, this building is full of dead bodies and skeletons.
It's full of ghosts and spirits. Oh, I can feel them. Oh, my head hurts.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Horrible. Dear Lord, please save these lost souls.
This must have happened a long time ago. Oh, and the power is so strong. If I can channel some of these spirits, maybe I can find out what happened here.
Channel the spirits?
Shame on you! You two should be praying for their souls!
The spirits floating in this room. I can let them possess my body so they can talk. Oh, the reason I came here is I heard the cry of one particular female voice. She was...
I will not stand for this! Not only do you not believe in God, but now you're going to disturb the spirits?
Shut up! Would you stop bothering me? Chains. And darkness. Death. Oh, no. There were so many of them. This is hell.
What? What's going on?
Oh, they were imprisoned and tortured. And, oh, thousands of them.
Kill them! They cut off my fingers. They crushed my legs. They smashed my head and cut out my guts. They took everything from me. They locked me up and chopped my body.
Oh, my eyes! Oh, my ears! Oh, they're burned! Help! Help! How horrible. This place used to be a prison. For hundreds of years, kept in secret. Whoever went against the authorities or misconducted themselves in any way were locked up here and killed.
No! Don't touch me! You piss off! Go to hell!
Hey. Hey. Wait a minute. Hey.
Edward.
You should have just died before. I wanted you to lay down and die.
A ghost?
Thank you.
Did you see all those bodies? Be quite a party if they were alive.
They've probably been abandoned for hundreds of years. Must be some fascinating old stories.
I saw some pretty fresh ones, too. One who was shot. One who'd been cracked in the head with an axe. And some with no visible signs of injury. They must have been poisoned.
I bet the new ones were fortune seekers like us. That old couple must
You mean to tell me they killed all those people? Rubbish!
All those deaths are rubbish?
They're all liars and thieves anyway. This is still a monastery. This is still God's house, prison or no. Why all those liars and heathens are killed is none of my concern.
How could you possibly say a thing like that? That doesn't sound very priestly.
I am not a priest. I am a bishop.
I don't give a rat's ass what you are. Look, I'm not saying that all of those people were saints, okay? But that doesn't mean that they should be put to death.
You saw that old couple. They're so well-mannered, kind. You think they're killers?
Good manners?
Yes.
Think about it! Why would they leave the place such a mess?
I don't know.
You think they'd at least bury the body?
Possibly.
Anyway, I have this strange feeling we're not alone with all these bodies and ghosts. You'd better keep your mouths shut, if you want to live.
Thank you. Koudelka, did you find anything?
No, nothing, but... Darn!
How does it look? You think we can get out?
I don't think so. You'd need the strength of a bear to break those bars with your hands.
What do you mean we can't get out? How hard can it be?
Why don't you ask these guys?
Damn it! Did you see that? Someone's in here.
Will you shut up and get us out of here? How hard can it be for thieves like you to get us out of a place like this?
Try saying that in the East End, holy man. Your severed head would hit the ground before you even finished the thought.
This is worthless. I can't believe I'm wasting my time on you. I'm on a mission from God.
What a waste. Such a terrible waste. My name's Charlotte. Not that it means anything. Not that you have a prayer. I'm talking to three dead people. Nobody's gonna save you. Nobody.
So you died here as well?
Yes. I died here too, hundreds and hundreds of years ago. They locked me up in here right after I was born. They beheaded me the day I turned 9. Happy birthday. I've been trapped here ever since, and no one even knows who I am.
My poor little angel.
Poor little angel, me? Save your pity for yourself. You'll be dead within 3 days.
Not true. I don't know what your circumstances are, but I know that your mother loved you very, very much.
My mother? I don't know her face, her name, where she came from. Nothing. You're telling me that means nothing? From the day I was born, day I die, no one ever loved me. And I never want to be loved. Just die. All of you. Just die!
Thank you. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I can't believe these treasures are in this monastery. Is that Montaigne's signature? Oh, that's a Caravaggio. Unbelievable, truly. Why have these treasures been forgotten?
Treasures.
If these treasures can be contributed to the Vatican, their value to Christianity is unquantifiable. What a discovery.
Do you remember what this place is? It's not just a monastery, it was a prison. People were executed for fighting each other for supremacy. These treasures must have been taken from them, soaked with curses and hatred. You'll be cursed if you worship those things.
I am a busy man that does not have the patience to teach you the importance of faith. But I will tell you why we have found these treasures. It could only have come from the guidance of God. God sees all, he knows all. Got it?
Preach to the converted.
What about you, Edward? You seem a little more educated than she.
I don't really care. Talk to me about monetary value. Save the holy crap.
It seems I'm disappointed once again. I believe these dead thieves are better than you two. At least they appreciated true value.
Instead of preaching, I want you to understand something, okay? You can't label all those dead bodies as thieves hunting treasure. I saw plenty of dead women who were cut up and mixed in with the mummies, and they were pretty fresh.
Yeah. Strange. Even if I were used to seeing dead bodies, I'd be vomiting.
So it is that couple. But why?
Fools! How could such a kind and faithful couple be cold-blooded killers? This is the work of jealousy and greed, and pagans born of savagery. Immigrants. I will not be a party to such abusive slander. This is so unpleasant.
Thank you.
Always blame everything on the savagery of pagans. Are all men of the cloth like that?
It's senseless to tell you this, but the truth is...
What the?
Thank you. thief!
He's been sneaking around in the shadows and sniffing for treasure.
Just like us.
Well, sir, explain yourself. It's as plain as day this ruffian's a bloodthirsty killer who's been chasing us. Where are you from, Hamburg? Not that it really matters. You're obviously a dirty immigrant thief. Probably infected with cholera or something, most of you are.
None of your business where I was born, you bastard!
Look, I don't really care where you were born, and I agree. He is a bastard. But tell me, did you kill all these people?
Look, I'm an immigrant. I'm a thief, and maybe I did drop a chandelier on you. But that's just because I wanted the whole pie for myself.
So you did kill all these people?
No. I swear to God. Not your god, bigot.
What do you mean?
It was the couple. The couple who look after this place.
What?
I'm telling you the truth. I've seen them. I've been down here a long time. Usually they use an axe when they catch thieves. The thieves come down here unarmed. They're stupid. They get caught from behind. I'd watch my back if I were you.
Unbelievable.
No, I'm telling you. The lucky ones die on the first strike. I've heard the others screaming through the night, clutching their bellies. I find them in the morning dead. No, I'm telling you, their fingers to their hearts. Right through to their organs with a pain. Look, take it or leave it. But I'm telling you the truth, those two, they're Satan incarnate. I may look shady, but killing's not my style. Look, the more wholesome they look on the outside, the colder and uglier the heart is. Just look at him!
Yeah, good assessment for a thief.
You're crazy if you believe this, scoundrel. This killer's obviously executed hundreds of people. He needs to be turned into the police and judged in a proper forum.
We're crazy. Why? Just because he's an immigrant? Or is it because he's one of the unsaved? That's bull and you know it, you pig-headed old bigot!
What I'm trying to say is...
I believe this guy! Thieves can be exceedingly honest, you know? Still, he did try to kill us. For that.
What did you do that for?
If our lives cease being threatened, then it's a victory for God and all his glory, right? But if we go on letting them attack us, then the filthy, godless pagans win. Which would you like to bet on?
Hey, what's this? The Princess Alice? Well, she was a pleasure boat that went down in a terrible accident in the Thames. This one too. And this one. What's going on? They're all the Princess Alice. What is going on?